Maybe if I hold my breath, it won't be too bad. Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, Chemistry PhD and Tea Addict. And today we're going to be talking about an ingredient that's as old as fire. And it's getting more popular as the word detox. It's activated charcoal. You'll find activated charcoal in products like face cleansers, face masks, toothpaste, and even supplements. What is activated charcoal? What does it do? And does it work? Here's the science. Charcoal is carbon soot that's made from burning organic matter. Usually this is plants, but anything that's biological and carbon-based will work. Activated charcoal is charcoal that's been treated to give it a sponge-like texture, with lots and lots of holes. If you zoom into activated charcoal, it's very jaggedy, giving it a huge surface area. Some scientists have estimated that 1 gram of activated charcoal, which is this much, has a surface area of about 3,000 square meters. This is about 3 Olympic swimming pools, or 7 basketball courts, or 230 car park spaces. Activated charcoal is used by a lot of chemical-free kinds of companies. So I thought I'd make a side note to clarify that, yes, charcoal is actually a chemical. It's made of carbon and it's on the periodic table right here. If you also want a smartass molecule mug to annoy your co-workers with, or if you're looking for a gift for a friend who won't shut up about science, check out these Lab Muffin mugs. I have another video on the myths about natural versus chemical beauty products, which I'll link in the description. So activated charcoal has this massive surface area, but what's so great about having so much space? If you zoom in to molecules at a microscopic level, you'll discover that everything is slightly sticky. Molecules like to cling onto each other. That's why water has surface tension, and why particles in solids and liquids don't spread out and turn into gases unless you put a lot of heat into them. These sticky forces are called intermolecular forces, which work a little bit like magnets. Everything is kind of a little bit magnetic. Because activated charcoal has such a big surface area, that means there's tons of space for substances to stick to. For example, if you have a glass of water with dye and you stir activated charcoal in it, once a dye molecule bashes into a piece of charcoal, it's stuck. And it's the same with an orange fizzy drink, the brand of which I'm not going to say. This is massively sped up because if you've ever tried filtering anything in real life, you know it takes forever.
I look like a footballer or something.
Tough footballer explains skincare.
This stuff smells really nasty. It's like rotten eggs or something. I think it's because I bought the activated charcoal off eBay, which now I know is not something you should do if you're intending to drink it. It's got a bouquet of farts. So rotten egg gas is hydrogen sulfide, and apparently if you can smell it, it's already a toxic dose. So I don't think I'm going to die, per se. Maybe if I hold my breath, it won't be too bad. It actually tastes okay. It's kind of just sugary water. There's not much of an orange flavor anymore. But maybe that's just covered up by the farts. This one's definitely more sour. Yeah, I think they're about the same sweetness. Just that this is missing all the sour flavor, so it just tastes really bland and watery. Most of the fart smell's gone, or maybe my nose has just died.
Now, you might have heard that charcoal works like a magnet, which makes you think that maybe the charcoal might be able to drag out dirt from deep inside pores. But that's not actually how it works. Activated charcoal needs to basically bash into the dirt for it to stick. It's more like a big ball covered in glue rather than a magnet. But a big ball covered in glue isn't really as catchy as like a magnet, so nope, the marketing teams decided to stick with magnet. So why do people use activated charcoal for detoxing? Well, in medicine, activated charcoal is only really used for poisoning cases. So this is when you want to soak up as much stuff as possible from the stomach and gut so it doesn't absorb into your body and kill you. Instead, what you'll do is you end up pooping out the poison-covered charcoal and you go about the rest of your life not dead.
Yay!
So since it's a common treatment for soaking up actual toxins that can kill you, the logic goes something like, the charcoal has some sort of special attraction for toxins, and so if you eat it normally, then it also soaks up the toxins from your body. Unfortunately, that's not how it actually works, because science is kind of convenient and sometimes a bit of a dick. The thing is, activated charcoal doesn't really have a brain, it's just a sticky sponge. And this sponge can't tell the difference between a good molecule and a bad molecule. It can't tell if something is a good nutrient that you want to let absorb into your body or a poison that you want to suck out. It just soaks it up using these dispersion forces, which is a type of intermolecular force. Activated charcoal has a kind of intermolecular force that absolutely everything else can stick to, something called dispersion forces. When two substances come really close together, their electrons move and they stick together. This happens with every type of substance, so at a basic level, everything is very sticky. Because activated charcoal has such a huge surface area because of all the holes in it, there's tons of space for everything to stick to. Anything that sticks to charcoal more strongly than it sticks to water will be removed by the activated charcoal. This includes toxins, but also vitamins and medications. Activated charcoal will stick onto all of these and stop them from completely going into your body. This means you won't get the full benefit of the nutrients or your medications. And most of the time, this is not what you want. If you've been poisoned, then nutrients are probably not so important right at that very second. But if you're eating activated charcoal as part of your regular diet, then it probably isn't making you any healthier. On the other hand, in skincare, when you put activated charcoal on your face, you generally don't apply it at the same time as your beauty products, which have your beneficial ingredients. So it isn't as much of an issue. Now back to this idea of it working a bit like a magnet. The problem with this explanation is that dispersion forces fade out very quickly as the two substances get further away from each other. As you might already know, if you have magnets, they stick together when they're close, but further apart, they don't really feel each other's attraction. Dispersion forces are even weaker than this with distance. They fade out much faster than magnets, and so for activated charcoal to stick to something and trap it, it pretty much needs to be touching. So it's better to think of activated charcoal as a big ball covered in glue rather than a magnet. This means it isn't going to draw out impurities from deep inside your pores or toxins from your bloodstream or anything like that. What activated charcoal can potentially do is help soak up oil and dirt from the surface of your skin, sort of like a clay mask. It might also be able to soak up some oil from your pores as well, and so it could suck this oil up, and if this oil has dirt in it, it could draw out some dirt from your pores better than, say, a normal cleanser. But how long does the charcoal need to be on your skin for it to actually do anything? Unfortunately, there isn't any data available on this. It's also questionable whether it could do anything when it's suspended in like a gloopy mask. It won't be able to collide with the dirt on your skin, and so it might not actually be able to get rid of it. I put two activated charcoal skincare products into the orange drink, a gel patch and a piece of sheet mask, and waited 5 minutes. You can see that the orange drink is still the same color. You don't see any of the fading that happened with the plain activated charcoal. There are other ingredients in these products that are good for hydrating your skin, but I'm pretty skeptical that the activated charcoal is actually doing much, because it just isn't able to make close contact with your skin. So theoretically, that's how activated charcoal could potentially work in skincare. Activated charcoal is pretty cheap and it's pretty harmless, so I think it's a pretty good product to try on your skin. But I wouldn't take an activated charcoal supplement regularly. At the very best, it's a waste of money that could make you constipated. At worst, it can stop nutrients and medications from getting absorbed into your body. Have you tried charcoal before? What did you think? Let me know in the comments. If you have a skincare ingredient or a skincare product that you want me to talk about next, let me know as well. I try to upload videos every second Thursday. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, I'd really appreciate it if you subscribed to my channel and also liked my video. I also regularly talk about the science behind beauty products on my blog and on my Instagram. And see you next time for more beauty science.